Hello students, today we are going to discuss pharmacology questions of AIIMS November 2019. So starting with the first question, which of the following is used for treatment of Pouci bacillary leprosy? Now again, this question is based on the recent changes in the leprosy treatment guidelines. So what are the changes? Let's look at them. So as per the latest guidelines, now treatment of Pouci bacillary leprosy is same as multibacillary leprosy. Only the duration differs. Duration is different as per the latest guidelines. So let's look at the treatment. Patient comes to healthcare center on day one. Patient comes to healthcare center and in front of the healthcare worker, that is under supervision, he will take rifampicin 600 milligram, and this will be taken once in a month. So rifampicin he will take 600 milligram on day one of each month. Second, he will take dapsone. This he will take 100 milligram on day one in front of healthcare worker. And third tablet he will take as clofazimine. Clofazimine he will take half of rifampicin, that is 300 milligram, and this will be taken once a month. So on day one of each month, the patient will come to healthcare center and in front of healthcare worker he'll take these three tablets, rifampicin, dapsone and clofazimine. Then what will happen? From day 2 to 28, he will be given a blister pack to take home, and the rest of the treatment for the next 28 days he'll take home under his own supervision, that is self, without the supervision of any healthcare worker. What he'll take? He'll take dapsone 100 milligram daily. So daily he'll take a tablet of dapsone and clofazimine. Clofazimine he'll take half of dapsone, that is 50 milligram daily. So from 2 to 28 day of each month, he'll take dapsone 100 milligram per day and clofazimine 50 milligram per day at home under his own supervision or without the supervision of any healthcare worker. So this is the treatment of leprosy today. As I said, the treatment remains same for Pouci and multibacillary, only the duration is different. So now what is the duration? For Pouci bacillary, the same treatment will be given for 6 months. And for multibacillary, the same treatment will be given for 12 months. So only the duration differs. So as far as the question is concerned, which of the following is used for treatment of Pouci bacillary leprosy? We can see that we are using three drugs for 6 months. So option C is the correct answer. So this is a question based on the latest changes in the leprosy treatment guidelines. Moving on to question number 2. Now again, question number 2 is based on a recent drug. So we can see that AIIMS is trying to ask in pharmacology the recent changes or the recently approved drugs. Tafenoquine has been asked, which of the following is clinical use of tafenoquine? The answer will be that this drug is used for radical cure of vivax. So option number A, radical cure of Plasmodium vivax is the answer. So let's look at what is tafenoquine. Now tafenoquine is a drug which is similar to primaquine. It is more or less similar to primaquine. Now what do we know about primaquine? We know that primaquine is used for radical cure. What is radical cure? Radical cure is prevention. PX stands for prevention of relapse. That is the meaning of radical cure. How can a drug be useful in radical cure only if it is killing hypnozoites or sleeping forms. So primaquine kills the hypnozoites. Hypnozoites, the stage is also known as exoerythrocytic stage. So it is acting in exoerythrocytic stage or hypnozoites. In which type of malaria do we find this stage? Only in Vivex, not in falciparum. So in Vivex we mainly use it. What is the dose? 0.25 milligram per kg per day, and it is given for 14 days. That is the dose of primaquine. What are the side effects or contraindications of primaquine? The side effect is mainly hemolysis. And where are the risk of hemolysis more? In three groups of people. People who are deficient in G6PD enzyme, there are more risk of hemolysis. Secondly, pregnancy. Please remember, pregnancy is a physiological G6PD deficient state. And third are infants. So the risk of hemolysis is more in these three groups of patient, and therefore primaquine should not be given in these three groups of patient. So this we know about primaquine. The same use is there for tefenoquine also. It is also for radical cure. So it will also kill the hypnozoid or the exoerythrocytic stage. It is also used for prevention of relapse in Vivex, that is the radical cure. It is also contraindicated in patients who are likely to develop G6PD hemolysis. Then what is different? What is examiner trying to ask? Only one point is that this drug has a much longer T-half than primaquine. Its T-half is somewhere around 2 weeks. And because of its such a long T-half, instead of 14-day treatment, a single dose of 300 milligram, single oral dose of 300 milligram is sufficient to cause the radical cure instead of 14 days that were required with primaquine. So tefenoquine has been developed as a longer acting version of primaquine. Mechanism of action of both drugs is same. They release free radical and cause damage to the hypnozoites. So tefenoquine is used as a single dose radical cure, 300 milligram oral dose for radical cure of plasmodium vivax. So this is the answer to question number 2. Moving on, question number 3. Again we can see that most of the drugs which are given are relatively newly approved drugs. So again we need to remember, AIIMS is trying to ask the recent drugs or the recent changes. We need to keep an eye on such topics. Now this is a match the following question. So we are given two columns. In column A, there are drugs, 4 drugs, and in column B, the mechanisms of their action are given and we need to match them. So let's look at these drugs one by one. Omalizumab. Now omalizumab is a pretty simple one. We should know it is a drug used in asthma against IgE. So it mechanism is option number C. It is anti-IgE. Itolizumab is a new antibody which is against psoriasis and it is against anti-CD6, so option is A. Daclizumab we will see is against anti-CD25. What is anti-CD25? We will discuss, so option is B. And Belimumab is an antibody used in SLE and it is against B lymphocyte stimulator, so option is E. So we have correctly marked the answer. Let's look at the important points. Omalizumab is a monoclonal antibody. Mab refers to monoclonal antibody against IgE. Number one thing, it is used in severe uncontrolled asthma, not controlled on the maximum doses of glucocorticoids and beta agonist, and it is given by subcutaneous injection. subcutaneous injection. This point has been asked repeatedly. Now, since they have asked an antibody in asthma, we should also see if there are some other antibodies available for treatment of asthma. And we find that there are certain anti-interleukin 5 monoclonal antibodies which are also available now for treatment of asthma. Which are these antibodies? Number one, benralizumab, mepolizumab and reslizumab. Benralizumab, mepolizumab and reslizumab. These are three antibodies, all of which are against interleukin 5. Out of these antibodies, reslizumab is the one which is given intravenously. Rest of the two are given subcutaneously. So most of the antibodies, remember, are given by subcutaneous route. So if this question is asked, and if you don't know, the best answer to take is subcutaneous. Only few antibodies are given intravenously, like reslizumab. So that is an important point to remember. Second thing, interleukin 5 is a growth factor for eosinophils. So all these antibodies are used for eosinophilic type of asthma. So that is the other important thing to remember in asthma regarding the antibodies. Then we come to itolizumab. What is itolizumab? Itolizumab is a monoclonal antibody which is against CD6. What is CD6? CD6 is a pan T-cell marker. So it is an antibody that will inhibit T cell and it will reduce the inflammation seen in psoriasis. So that is the use of itolizumab. Now this CD6 has created a lot of confusion in the minds of students. Why? Because they have confused CD6 with interleukin 6. So remember, CD6 is a marker of T cell antigen present on T cell, and interleukin 6, all of you know, is a type of cytokinin. Now there is a very important and much more commonly asked antibody against interleukin 6, and that is the source of confusion. So antibody against interleukin 6 is known as tocilizumab. Tocilizumab is an antibody which blocks interleukin 6. So that is an antibody, monoclonal antibody against interleukin 6, and tocilizumab is very commonly asked and used for treatment of rheumatoid arthritis. So please remember, interleukin 6 and CD6, they are different things and antibodies. One is used in rheumatoid arthritis, tocilizumab, and itolizumab is used in psoriasis. Moving to third option, daclizumab shares its mechanism of action with another antibody known as basiliximab. Both are antibodies, monoclonal antibody that block against interleukin 2 receptor. So both are antibody against interleukin 2 receptor. So there is an interleukin 2 which binds to its receptor on T cells, that is interleukin 2 receptor. Now, exact binding site on interleukin 2 receptor is known as an antigen known as CD25. So what is CD25? CD25 is a part of interleukin 2 receptor. It is one of the subunit of interleukin 2 receptors, and these two antibodies, daclizumab and basiliximab, they bind to CD25 antigen on interleukin 2 receptor. So most of the time, the question which is asked is daclizumab or basiliximab, their antibody against interleukin-2 receptor. But this time AIIMS has gone one step ahead and they have asked the exact binding site on interleukin-2 receptor, that is CD25 subunit of interleukin-2 receptor. So that is the mechanism of daclizumab and basiliximab. Now basiliximab and daclizumab differ in their use. Basiliximab is used as an immunosuppressant. Immunosuppressant to prevent the transplant rejection after kidney transplant, while daclizumab is mostly used for multiple sclerosis. That is the main use. Although if you will read the latest information, you will find the use of daclizumab is mostly now history. It is no longer used. So this is about daclizumab and basiliximab. Last one given in the option remaining is belimumab. Belimumab is known as anti-bliss. What is bil? L-Y-S. It is anti-B lymphocyte stimulator. So as the name suggests, it is anti-B lymphocyte stimulator. It will decrease the proliferation of B lymphocytes, and belimumab finds a use in SLE. So these are the various drugs that were provided and the points related to these drugs. Moving on to question number 4. Which of the following is true or false regarding drugs used for viral infections? Again, this question gives us 5 options and we have to mark each of them true or false. So in fact, we are looking at 5 questions. Now this is one of the new pattern of questions that is asked in AIIMS. Now if we look at the option, again we find that there are mention of cimeprovir, ombitasvir, sofosbuvir. So again, these are new drugs. So again, we have a question asking about the new drugs. So let's look at these drugs in a collective manner.